So we're going to be talking about sensory loss or pain or paresthesia complaints in the lower extremity. And we're going to be considering in this case whether the problem is from the nerve root and therefore the issue with the sensory loss is coming from a dermatome, and I'll abbreviate dermatome, or the problem is coming from a peripheral nerve issue. And in this case, the problem would be located at a pure patch. And as we dealt with in the upper extremities in these videos, when somebody has a complaint in a certain area, you have to consider what nerve root it could be and do the MRS for that, and then what peripheral nerve that could be and do the MRS for that. MRS standing for motor, reflex, or sensory evaluation. So to start out with, I'm going to just draw leg hair for you. Do the best I can. It's a little bit tough. That's kind of the knee area. Then the lower leg comes in here, and there's an ankle and some toes. It's the big toe, and we've got the other toes coming in over here. And then draw this out a little bit, and then the lateral leg, lateral malleolus into the side of the foot. It's a little scary, but I think it'll do. So to start out with the dermatomes, we've got a top area right here that would be known as L1. And I'm just going to draw some lines here and call this L1. And then there's one right below it, which is L2. I'll draw some dots in there. And then right below that, there is L3. We say L3 is kind of across the knee to include the vastus medialis belly. I'll make some lines go the other way. On the lower leg, we've got further divisions. We've got L4, which is on the medial side of the leg into the medial arch. We've got L5, which is on the lateral side of the leg and then splits off and just takes the top of the foot. The entire dorsum of the foot would be considered L5. And the last dermatome that we're going to be considering is the lateral side of the foot, just the side of the foot to the side of the fifth digit, and this is S1. So the next one we have to talk about are the sensory areas for the peripheral nerves. And when we talk about the peripheral nerves, the pure patch for the femoral nerve overlies the top of the thigh. I'm just going to color that in a little bit. So if the patient comes in with a sensory loss or pain or paresthesias along the center of the front of their thigh, I've got to think about it being possibly the femoral nerve and do the MRS for the femoral nerve, the motor, reflex, and sensory evaluation. Or I've got to think that this is potentially L1 and or L2 and or L3 and do the MRSs for L1 and L2 and L3. Another peripheral nerve has a pure patch right over the head of the fibula, and this is a pure patch for the common peroneal nerve. And so if the patient had sensory loss over this area, right over the head of the fibula, I would do the MRS for the common peroneal nerve and the MRS for L5. Also on the side of the leg, we have pure patches just along the lateral lower leg. This is the pure patch for the superficial peroneal nerve. And you can see from its location that if the patient had complaints over the lateral leg, numbness, paresthesias, or pain, I would do the MRS for the superficial peroneal nerve, and I would do the MRS again for L5. Now, to make this a little bit clearer down here on the top of the foot, we have a deep peroneal nerve pure patch that sits right between the first and second toe. This is between the big toe and the second toe. This, as I just mentioned, is the deep peroneal nerve pure patch. I'll abbreviate P for peroneal and N for nerve. And it also, and it's tough to tell from this picture, but it also overlies L5. So we really have so far three different pure patches that overlap L5. So if the patient had pain and paresthesias on the dorsum of their foot, on the top of their foot, I'm thinking, especially see if it's between the first and second digits, maybe the deep peroneal nerve, and I would do the MRS for the deep peroneal nerve, and I would also do the MRS for L5. We had another pure patch a little bit higher here, and it lies right over the vastus medialis muscle belly, and obviously superficially. And this is the pure patch for the obturator nerve. And if the patient had pain or paresthesias in that area, then I would do the MRS for the obturator nerve and the MRS for L3. My positive findings are going to tell me what where the problem is. We're also going to eventually add orthopedics to this evaluation. We have one more pure patch, and that pure patch lives on the bottom of the foot along the heel. And if I were to draw the bottom of a foot, here's the big toe, second, third, fourth, and fifth, just like this. The heel of that foot is a pure patch for the tibial nerve. And the tibial nerve overlies a dermatome that would also be considered potentially S1. You might also want to do S2 MRS, but that's not included in the subject matter for this particular video. But that covers all the peripheral nerve pure patches and also the dermatomes, and will help you along when a patient has sensory complaints about which peripheral nerve and which nerve root to evaluate.